Hi, I'm Paula Corley. You can probably tell I'm not from Paris. This is my first trip here and I'm very excited to visit Vandoren. I've been a longtime fan of Vandoren. I started on the blue box, the purple box that used to look like this a long time ago, and I started on a 2RV. My director that started me on clarinet talked about the importance of having really good equipment right from the start, so I was very lucky. Currently, I live in Texas and I live near Austin. I am a teacher at Texas Lutheran University in Seguin, and I also continue to teach high school and junior high students as well. My best piece of advice for a developing player is to get a good mouthpiece and good reeds to start. The truth is, the instrument doesn't make as much difference as the mouthpiece and the reed. All of the Vandoren products are good. My favorites, personally, for a student just starting would be the 5RV Lyre. And the reason why I would recommend that is because it's in the middle. And if you look at the chart, the ones that we get in the United States, it's medium. It's a good place to start. Probably won't be your last one, but it's a good place to start. I also really love the blue box traditional reeds. They work really well for me in Texas. You can start with a 3 and maybe eventually go to a 3.5. If you live in other parts of the country, you'll have to consider the humidity, the elevation. I've lived in different parts of the country and played Rue Le Pique. I have played V12, I like them as well, but currently the blue box work really well for me. Let's talk about ligatures. When the MO came out, I was extremely excited. It's the best ligature that I've ever found. I've tried many others with my students and myself, and hands down, it's my favorite design. I think it allows the reed to vibrate freely, but you still have a good sense of control. I really love the fact that Vandoren offers several different price points. I play the gold. I like the warm sound that the gold gives. I also have the silver one. It gives you a lot of zing, and my students usually start on pewter, and they love them as well, and they work really well. My preferred mouthpieces for bass would be B44. The reason why I choose that one is because, again, it's in the middle. I don't play bass a lot, but when I do, I use a B44. I like the optimum ligature for that, and again, the traditional reeds. E-flat clarinet, B44 as well. Works really well for me, and there are probably a lot of people out there saying, I'm glad she doesn't play E-flat very much, but that is also a very good in-the-middle mouthpiece and works really well. As I said, I've had a long-standing association with the company even before I became one of the artists. I've been playing Vandoren products since I was 11, and I'm a lot older than that, as you can tell right at this moment. I'm always full of advice, so let's discuss developing players for a minute. I think the biggest thing you need to work on is developing a plan for practice. So many students pick pieces at random, or they pick etudes and materials that are not appropriate for the level at which they are playing. So think carefully about the materials that you choose to practice. Practice the right things. That would include some type of long tone or register shift. I'm really big on being able to navigate from the Shalumeau to the clarion register. So anything that would facilitate that. Can't get away from scales. Need to spend a good portion of your practice on scales, both slurred and articulated. And then as far as your solos and your repertoire is concerned, choose wisely. If you've only played a year, don't try to play the Copland, okay? So just choose wisely and practice wisely and you will make much faster progress and be a lot better at playing the instrument.